third video lesson of the group dedicated to Virginia Woolf, James Joyce, and the stream of consciousness finally concentrates on the figure of James Joyce. He was born in Dublin in a large Catholic family, and after graduating in modern languages at university colleges, he left Dublin for good in therefore 1902, moving on the continent. At first he settled in Trieste, where he lived for some time, because Trieste represented the city, the most cosmopolitan city, set in what was then considered the heart of Europe, at a time during which Europe was the center of cultural development and the place to be in order to experiment with new aesthetics and with new approaches to art. Here he even came in contact with Italo Svevo, which who in turn became a famous writer on his own. He supported himself for a while in Trieste by working as a translator and by teaching English. At the break of World War I, he was forced to leave Trieste, because being so close to Austria and being Italy an ally of the German forces, it had become dangerous for him, being a British citizen. At first he moved to Switzerland, then later to Paris, and then back to Switzerland, where he died in 1941. He seldomly went back to his native country, and specifically to Dublin during these years, but in one of those rare trips he met Nora, who followed him back to Trieste, where their two children were born, and they were named Giorgio and Lucia. They eventually married only in 1931. However, despite his estrangement from Dublin, the city is ever present and inspires all his works. James Joyce was a very controversial writer, whose works were subjected to censorship and often faced legal suits and even public trials, as in the case of excuse me, Ulysses, which is his most notable novel, that went through a public scandal indeed, and Joyce had to was brought to court in the United States, where it had to be settled whether the novel was pornographic or not. This is to what extent the controversy went to. This caused him obviously not only financial hardship, but also great professional frustration and disappointment. The reason why probably his works were so controversial at the time of his writing is probably because, as we've said, he brought the stream of consciousness that Virginia Woolf had experimented and developed to its extremes. We will see in detail what this means, but it needs to be underlined that in order to achieve the realistic a deep investigation of an individual's mind, Joyce resorted to describing every single aspect of the character's daily activity without leaving out any of them. This may have caused not only irritation, but probably some misgivings in the readers that of the time, who obviously were not accustomed to this type of literature, which they questioned as literature. But let's see how Joyce develops his literary outlook. As we said, he focused on describing even the smallest details of the individual's mind, and to do so, he wanted to reach the total impersonality of the author. He strives to accomplish the absolute author's absence from his own narration. In his way of seeing the artist, Joyce believed that the writer's ultimate goal was to portray life as it really was, as objectively and realistic as he possibly could. Therefore, in doing so, the author had to totally disappear from his work, and he had to reach complete detachment as an author from his or her characters. And to do so, the artist needed to be totally isolated from society, because he wanted to portray the inner being of the individual of the time, of the 20th century, with all his or her inner solitude, his or her alienation from the world, and the deep inner turmoil that the individual of the 20th century was experiencing. As we said, it is a time of great uncertainty, of deep anxiety, during which all the standpoints that had characterized previous eras totally disappear, and there is a growing mistrust in any type of progress and any type of dreamed universal well-being. So Joyce, in order to reach his goal, he then had to use a great number of writing techniques. So, as said, the stream of consciousness that derived from the interior monologue is here brought to further steps, and it needs to be coupled with a second level of narration. In other words, Joyce, on the one hand, has an outside description, illustration of the surrounding world, of the characters, and the interactions with this outside world, while at the same time, next to it, we also have the inner narration that focuses on the characters' mind, reporting, and this is what causes controversy and in many cases scandal, a constant flow of thoughts, feelings, associations of ideas, replicating what happens in real life. Therefore, with no interruptions, often with no punctuation, because he says it is the way, it is necessary in order to reproduce what actually happens in everyone's mind at any given time of our daily life. This also entails a great effort on the part of the reader, who is now invited into the work itself. It needs to bring his or her contribution. It's not merely a passive reading, an amusing reading, entertaining. It needs the active participation of the reader. And these two levels of narration, so the interior monologue and the outside description of and the description of the outer world are intertwined and connected and are meant to portray the actual disarray that occurs in the minds of people. Yet another technique that Joyce masters is the cinematic technique, meaning that through his savvy use of words, he is able to reproduce the camera movements, giving an idea of close-ups, of flashbacks, tracking shots, suspension of speech that that caused the holding of breath due to fear or astonishment. He masters dramatic dialogue, also the overlapping of events, molding from what appears to be chaos a structure and meaning, allowing the reader to catch the inner essence of his characters. Again, the main goal that he is trying to achieve through a collage technique, which was also used in cubist art. So it's a blending of different techniques. In other words, showing different perspectives from taking apart images and then putting them back together. In this way, he highlights the individual's multiple truths. His use of language is also incredibly rich in vocabulary registers. He goes from using slang to elevated levels of language according to his character's social background or the situation, and even resorting to catchphrases from advertisements. Moreover, he makes great use of quotations and references to other works, even using foreign words, which to a certain extent are somewhat disorienting for the reader, but at the same time challenging as well. To grasp and comprehend Joyce's main themes, which are paralysis and epiphany, it's necessary first to understand the role that Ireland and Dublin played in Joyce's imagery to the point of becoming a universal paradigm for this author, who left his native city very, very early in his life, and which we will discuss in our next video.